Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss systems of linear equations in two variables. Let's go ahead and work through an example. The questions say to solve this system of equations. So our first equation is 5x plus 3y equals 3, and our second equation is x plus 9y equals 2. Let's carefully work through this solution. There are a few ways to do this. I like to use what's called the elimination or the addition method. Basically, that means that you pick an equation and you multiply it by something so that when you add it to the other one, a variable cancels. For example, in this particular case, if we were to multiply the second equation by negative 5, we could add it to the first to get rid of the 5x. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's multiply the second equation by negative 5. So when we do that, I'm just going to write multiply. And I'll label them. I'll call this equation 1, equation 2, just so I can write it. So multiply equation 2 by negative 5. So when we do that, we get negative 5 times x, which is simply negative 5x. And then negative 5 times 9y is going to be minus 45y. And then negative 5 times 2 is negative 10. And now what I'm going to do just for clarity is I'm going to write this first equation right below it. So 5x plus 3y equals 3. Okay. So again, we just multiplied that second equation by negative 5, and then I wrote the first equation right below it. So now we're going to add. So when you add these, you get negative 5x plus 5x, which is 0. Negative 45y plus 3y is negative 42y. And negative 10 plus 3 is negative 7. So now what we can do is solve for y, right? We just divide by negative 42, divide by negative 42. So we end up with y equals, well, 7 goes into 42 six times, and we have two negatives, so we just get 1 over 6. I'm going to put that in a box. Good to have that. Now we have to find y. To find y, we can just plug it into either of the equations. I'm thinking we should use the second one here, x plus 9y equals 2. Let's go ahead and do that. We're going to take this y and just put it here, right there. It'll be x plus 9 times y, but y is 1 over 6. So 1 over 6, and that's equal to 2. Well, 9 over 6 is really 3 over 2, so we have x plus 3 halves equals 2. Now, I'm going to write 2 as 4 halves, just so it's easier to subtract. So now we have minus 3 halves, minus 3 halves. We have x equals 1 half. And so the answer would be x equals 1 half, y equals 1 sixth, or even better, you could write it as a point. It would be 1 half, comma 1 sixth. It's a point. What does this mean? This is where these two lines intersect. Each of these equations graphically can be represented by a line in the xy plane, and this ordered pair in the xy plane is the point where these two lines meet or intersect. That's the word we use. Anyways, kind of an interesting problem. Let's do a couple more examples. Solve the system of equations 2x plus 3y equals 1 and negative 4x minus 6y equals 7. Solution. So as before, let's try to eliminate variables. In this case, maybe we can just multiply the first equation by 2. Let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to multiply. And again, I'll number them. This is 1 and this is 2. So let's multiply that first equation by 2. When we do that, we get 2 times 2, which is 4x. 2 times 3, which is going to give us 6, and then we still have the y. And 2 times 1 is just 2. Then down here, we simply have negative 4x minus 6y equals 7, just writing that second equation right below it. And obviously, the reason we multiplied by 2 was that so we can eliminate the negative 4x, right? Because 4x plus negative 4x is 0. Now we add, just like before. Here we get 0 plus 0 equals 9. So we end up with 0 equals 9. What does that mean? Well, that's impossible. So no way. It doesn't make sense. So not possible. So it's never true. So basically that means that there is no solution. There is no solution. And another way to say it, if say you're asked for the solution set, you would say the solution set is the empty set. It's a set containing nothing in it. What's happening graphically here is that you have two lines that never intersect. If you think about it, if I draw a line here, I draw a line here, it intersects. So two lines that don't intersect, they must be parallel. So these lines here are parallel lines. Kind of interesting. So whenever you get the case where you get something silly like 0 equals 1, 0 equals 9, it's not possible, the answer is always no solution. If you're asked for the solution set, you can just say it's the empty set, which is this symbol here. And if you're asked what kinds of lines are these graphically, they are parallel lines. Let's go ahead and do one more example. Solve the system. Negative x plus y equals negative 1 and 3x minus 3y equals 3. Work through it. Solution. As before, we'll try to use the elimination method. In this case, it seems that if we multiply that first equation by 3, we'll get negative 3x there for that first term. We can add it to the second one and things will go away. So let's just go ahead and multiply it by 3. So I'm just going to say multiply that first equation by 3. And I'll go ahead and number the equations again. We have equation 1 and equation 2. So multiplying that first equation by 3, we're going to get negative 3x and plus 3y, and that's equal to negative 3. And then let's go ahead and write the second equation right below it. So we have 3x minus 3y equals 3. We add now, we get 0 plus 0 equals 0. We get 0 equals 0. So it's always true. This is always true, always true. In this case, you have what's called infinitely many solutions. And sometimes that's good enough. Sometimes that's all you have to write. However, I'm going to show you a couple different ways to write your answer. So first of all, what is the answer? If you have infinitely many solutions, what are they? Well, basically, what we have here graphically is we have a line, and then we have another line, but the other line is actually the same line. So it's one line on top of another line. So every single point on the line is a solution. Every single point is a point of intersection, because if you take a line and you put another line right on top of it, it's just you have infinitely many solutions, and your solutions are all the points in the line. The solution set is the set of ordered pairs x, y, such that x and y are on the line. What does that mean? What does it mean to be on the line? Well, it means that if you plug in your x and y into any of these equations, it's true. It means that negative x plus y equals negative 1. That's an acceptable answer. Some people like to use a third variable to find the answer. Here's another way to do it. So we know that this is one of our equations. You can solve this for y by adding x. We know that y is equal to x minus 1. What's x? Well, x is just x, right? So what people do is they say, hey, you know what? X is x. But instead of that, let's just let x be equal to t, where t is a real number. If you do that, then y becomes t minus 1. So it's all the ordered pairs of the form t, t minus 1, where t is a real number. So another way to write the answer is the set of ordered pairs of the form t, t minus 1, such that t is a real number. So different ways to write the answer. How you write it will depend on whatever you're doing, right? I mean, if you're doing this for fun, it doesn't matter. If you're doing it for a class, then just whatever's expected. So different ways to do it. And sometimes always true, or sometimes, you know, infinitely many solutions is enough. Hopefully you've learned a lot of math in this video. We've talked about quite a bit of mathematics. And if you feel like you have, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck. Take care.